I'm Sara, and today we're going to perform the skill of IV push. So I'm going to grab my patient's chart. Looks like here we have Morgan Brown, MR number 589-13-51325, date of birth 8-4-70. He has no known allergies. And it looks like there's an order here for morphine sulfate 2 milligrams IV push every 3 hours PRN. I was told that he is experiencing some pain. Before I administer the medication, I want to make sure that it's compatible with the IV fluids that he has infusing. So I'm looking here under morphine, and under incompatibilities, I do not see any issues with normal saline, so that's, we're good to go with that. I also want to look for any adverse effects, anything I should monitor after and before giving the medication. So I see here it's for moderate to severe pain. I want to monitor for any respiratory distress. I want to make sure that his pain relief occurs and that he's comfortable after administering the medication. That's how I know that the medication will be working. Now I'm going to prepare my medication. Sorry. I have morphine sulfate injection, 2 milligrams per ml, expiration date of 12/20/50, so that's good. I'm to give a dose of 2 milligrams, so I am going to make sure that since this says 2 milligrams per ml, I'm only going to draw up 1 milliliter. The date is today, the time is now. For Morgan Brown, date of birth 8-4-70, with no known allergies, and I will complete my documentation after I've administered the medication. Now I'm going to gather my supplies. Make sure I grab the right size syringe. Since I'm only giving 1 ml, I don't need a large syringe. I'm going to use this 3 ml syringe, a needleless cannula, and I want an alcohol swab. Okay. Now I'm going to perform my second check. Again, I have Morgan Brown, 8-4-70, no known allergies. I'm going to give morphine sulfate injection, 2 milligrams IV push every 3 hours. I have here 2 milligrams per ml. I'm only going to give 1 ml, expiration date of 12/20/50 today, and the time is now, and I will document later. I'm going to drop 1 milliliter of air since I'm giving 1 milliliter of medication. I'm going to inject the air. Remember to inject air to air and not air to medication, otherwise you're going to get a bunch of bubbles. Okay, we have 1 ml. I do not see any air bubbles in my syringe. If I were giving more than one medication at a time or not administering this medication immediately, I would want to label the syringe with the patient's name, medication, dose, and time. Okay, so again, I have morphine sulfate, 2 milligrams per ml. I drew up 1 ml to make 2 milligrams. Expiration date 12/20/50. For Morgan Brown, date of birth 8-4-70, no known allergy, the time is now and the day is today. I am now going to go to the room and administer the medication. Hi, Morgan. It's Sarah, your nurse. I'm here with your pain medication. Where are you experiencing pain right now?
Just in my chest.
Okay, can you tell me what your pain is on a scale of 0 to 10?
It's about a 7 right now.
Okay, how would you describe the pain? Is it nagging, stabbing, gnawing, aching, cramping?
It's crampy and consistent. It just doesn't go away.
Okay, I wonder if you're experiencing that chest pain from all that coughing you are doing. So I brought some medication for you. It's morphine. I'm gonna go ahead and give that to you, but before I do that, can you please tell me your name and date of birth?
Sure, it's Morgan Brown, 8470.
Great, that's what I have here. And you don't have any allergies, Morgan?
No, I don't.
Okay. So Morgan, I'm gonna administer this medication. Your pain should decrease and you should feel better after I administer it. If you start to feel uncomfortable or get any itching or notice that you're having any problems breathing after I administer, I want to make sure that you call me. Use your call light here and call me right away.
Okay.
So I'm going to use the hub closest to the patient. I'm going to scrub the hub for about 15 seconds. Make sure it's all clean. And prior to administering this, I double checked how fast I would want to administer the medication. Since it's an IV medication, we have to be very careful that we don't administer things too fast. So now I'm going to unscrew the syringe from the needleless device, connect it to the port. I'm going to use my clock on the wall while clamping down to make sure that my medication is going forward to the patient and not back up into the solution. So I have it kinked right here before the port. And I know that I'm to administer this medication over about 1 to 2 minutes. Okay, after I've injected the medication, I'm going to unclamp my tubing so my IV fluids can continue to flow. I'm going to put my syringe and my needleless device in the sharps container. Okay, Morgan, I administered your medication. I hope this is going to give you some relief. Use your call light to call me if you have any issues or if you need anything. Otherwise, I'll be back in about a half hour to check on you to make sure that the medication is working properly.
Okay.
Now I'm back at the nurse's station and I'm going to document the medication that I administered. I want to make sure that I document the right patient, right time and date, right dose, right medication, right route, and if the patient experienced any adverse effects and or to make sure that the patient had pain relief and the new pain assessment. This now concludes our skill of IV push.